Welcome to module 3 of our course, Understanding Incubation and Entrepreneurship, where we're going to learn innovation, team building, and problem statement. Today's lecture will have three sessions. The first session is on methodology of innovation. The second session is on team building. And the third session will discuss defining the problem statement. In the first session on methodology for innovation, I'm going to take you through the live case studies from the Shenoy Innovation Studio at IDC School of Design, IIT Bombay. Through these live case studies, I'm going to take you through the seven concerns of innovation, as well as the collaborative model of innovation, which is extremely critical for any new startup or entrepreneurship. The innovation methodology helps us come up with solutions which can delight a large number of users and get potential customers. Hence, this is extremely critical for our businesses and startups. The lecture also showcases how the innovation process requires empathy, meticulous effort, constant interaction with users, and effective collaboration. For today's lecture, let us discuss the startup story of Netflix. Netflix is the world's largest subscription-based video service provider, and it couldn't reach there very easily. The whole story started when Reed Hastings, the founder of Netflix, had rented an Apollo 13 cassette and forgot to return it. The video library charged a heavy fine of around $40, and that left him embarrassed. While he was working out in a gym, he realized that the payment model of the gym was very fair when compared to cassette rentals. This one idea of subscription triggered Netflix. At that time, in 1977, DVDs were just coming in, and that was an added advantage to Netflix. And it started sending DVDs by mail, and by 1999, they introduced a monthly subscription model. It was a big hit because customers could borrow a number of DVDs and become free from the hassles of due dates and shipping charges and late fees. Within 10 years, by 2007, Netflix introduced the subscription-based online video streaming, and there was no looking back after that. They started working on it immediately and put in the best engineers. In fact, Netflix is known for getting the best manpower in their teams. Netflix became very, very popular, and they got huge subscriptions thanks to excellent internet speeds and technology. We can see how the ecosystem around you and the environment around you can also push you to innovation and excellent business prospects. What is interesting is Netflix kept on innovating. They ventured into the film industry. They created films and serials. And on top of it, unlike the TV industry, the customer had the choice to watch all the episodes of the show at one go. The founders of Netflix were known for their software proficiency, and they built in artificial intelligence and algorithms to suggest what the customers would like to view, and this actually made it a very, very popular feature. Let me now take you to my lecture of session one, which is methodology for innovation.
If innovation has to be sort of, implemented, or you need to take it forward, you either need to go to industry, which is already established, so they can take your innovation forward, which is one example I show you of my petrol pump design. And of course, the second the best option, of course, is doing a startup. And when you do a startup, it is not the same user you're considering when you're designing a product. That was the biggest learning for me with those 2 weeks of classes with my colleagues in IIT Hyderabad. So before I start my innovation by design, let me talk about that one paradigm shift which we designers have to understand when we look at enterprises and when we look at innovation very closely, because design innovation are not the same, right? They're very different. So what is the difference between design and innovation? What is it? How do each of them address each other is the biggest challenge. And that's the reason for my logo, Innovation by Design, where design addresses innovation and the innovation process is designed. So, and then of course, now the management, schools have taken up the design thinking process, which is the management process for managing innovation. And all of us are so well versed with it. And then we keep saying that we are the experts of design thinking. Ye managers kahan se aage beech mein? You know, a number of times we ask this question. But of course, you know, that is the best part of design, which design thinking or design approach is, you know, can be applied in all contexts and all situations. You know, there was this famous American designer, Raymond Loewy, who started the first trains, who made the first copy machine, who made the first washing machine. You must look him up, Raymond Loewy. He would actually use design to even solve personal problems and societal problems, and also, you know, people, you know, who are not able to gel together, you know, for marriages. So design can really, you know, do all that. And all that is happening because you are very perseverant, because you ask the right questions, because you're ready to listen. And these are valuable traits. Students, when your colleagues and my colleagues in MIT and the faculty keep on sending you outside, survey karo, pucho, aao, that is the way we start, you know, learning what all is happening. So in fact, I'm very, very lucky that I, you know, did mechanical engineering. So when I do mechanical engineering and become a designer, I'm a different animal. When I do sciences and become a designer, I'm a different designer. And that brings into a very, very important aspect of collaboration and design. And all that I have, you know, told you in my online lectures, and we'll, of course, you know, like, you know, revisit some of it, you know, while we go ahead. And my grounding, of course, in, IIT Delhi, after my last tenure stint, was again very, very fabulous. I realized how research and technology could address design in a very big way. And how we need to, again, work very collaboratively with our professors over there. So I became a specialist in collaborative design because I saw that without collaboration, innovation cannot go forward. So my area of specialization is collaboration, and that too in the new product areas, new product design, we call it a new product. And within the new product, see, research is very narrow. The concept generation, remember the idea generation, what we do? I'm quickly ek sketch banate hain, bolte chalo yaar, ye sketch hamara final concept hai. Not right. And of course, now you can see that my L&T experience counted heavily when I did my IIT Delhi stint. And in the IIT Delhi, I had to study again, which was fabulous. I was studying with my management colleagues there, management school, part-time study. That really helped me. And then, for example, in my PhD, and then moved to IDC, IIT Bombay, as a professor, where, you know, we started, you know, multiple programs. And of course, now I head the Design Innovation Center at IIT Bombay. You know, we're trying to learn, still we're trying to learn, and this never-ending story. Okay, so now today I'm going to take you through my seven concerns. And these seven concerns form the backbone of the innovation process. And I'm going to show you these small, you know, videos of these concerns. So from the, you know, first concern, which is the cause, you know, in design and innovation, in both the cases, we are very, very focused on, you know, the type of commitment we have to solve the problem, right? In fact, that, you know, the concern to solve a problem, you know, is extremely, extremely critical, even for the innovation journey. And we call it the cause. And that one sentence we write for the cause has to be one sentence, students. A lot of my students would write a huge, of course, objective bahut bada hota hai, or cause bahut bada hota hai. Matlab nahi. If I'm designing a letterbox for India Post, my only cause was to design a maintenance-free letterbox. Unko maintenance-free chahiye tha. And all other things will come in automatically, right? So the cause becomes very important. And of course, here, look at this wonderful project we had where we designed a wind tracer. I'm very proud to say that this wind tracer has reached the president's hospital in Rashtrapati Bhavan, because this got the, you know, award during the, you know, like, Festival of Innovation conducted by Professor Anil Gupta of IIM Ahmedabad. And the Rashtrapati ji liked it so much that he asked us to supply one pilot production to him. So it's a very simple device where you could see the wind. And this whole thing started from that first lesson on design thinking, which is empathy, which is by visiting the location. So what we did in one course, we said, we'll just go and visit blood banks. We didn't We didn't plan what product to work on. When we visited BedBlanks, and the students kept on, you know, like talking to doctors, talking to people who came to give blood, and each student took one problem from the blood bank. To everlasting credit of Trivikram, who took this project, he said, "Sir, it's so painful that they have to prick 2-3 times. Why can't we have a simple device?" And of course, that is the way this device has come up. See, I told you about technology transfer. Now this is going to technology transfer to a company which is now going to manufacture this product and, you know, put it in the market. So there, the resolve to solve the problem is the key.
We designed and developed a vein detector using NIR spectroscopy, which highlights oxygenated veins. This is especially useful for small children, obese patients, as well as dark-skinned people. We designed a lightweight, portable, and a compact unit, which is also affordable and easy to use. This is especially needed as there is wide application in all medical services, ranging from anesthesia units, blood banks, and pediatric wards. The design process was evolutionary in nature. We tried out different configurations for our infrared light source so that we could get the most optimum results. We also checked up various forms by doing 3D printed models so that the caregiver can have very good grip on the product for single use operations. Our initial trials have resulted in very positive feedback from our anesthesia doctors as well as pediatric wards. Our aim at the Shenoy Innovation Studio IIT Bombay is to humanize technology. Through this product, we want to reach every hospital possible across India and the world.
The context, understanding the problem space and the environment. Very, very critical, students. In fact, we may do a number of lectures on the context. But then when we finally go to the context, we are making it very, very wide. We don't understand the problem space much. For example, yesterday, one of my students, Anaga, called up. She said, "Sir, I'm stuck. I'm working on this, you know, device to help dementia elders, you know, with some device." And she started making an app. I said, "Did you check up the context? Who are these elderly people? What is the age group? If it is the age group from 70 to 80, I know they're not comfortable with Android phones. So what are you making?" Then the new, you know, aid for, you know, remembering whether you're taking medicine or not is a small, you know, shaft with some rotating wheels. So you rotate the wheel as soon as you take a tablet and you remember, "Oh, I've taken the tablet." So that is the core of our understanding, where we need to narrow down the problem, narrow down the context. And the context is that if the elderly is in that age group and they're living in the cities and they don't have, you know, and of course, if they have, you know, they're living together or they're living in an old age home, all those factors will be very valuable in your understanding of the context. So here, for example, this is an eye-opener for me, students. When we invited the CRPF Jawans, 8 of them came to my lab and we were designing these bottles. And I must tell you, I must confess that I and my student, Devanshi, who was an NID, you know, graduate, came to do MDes with us. You know, we were in the project, and in fact, I myself, you know, didn't push her enough to go and meet the Jawans for whom we were designing the bottle. And then there was this jury. We have pre-juries and multiple presentations, 4 presentations for every project. And to the everlasting credit of my colleagues, you know, like in the department, they said, "Nothing doing. If you're not spoken to the user, we're not buying anything from you. None of your presentation is valid." See, a senior professor guiding a student and not insisting on meeting the user just because that is a mushkil hai. Matlab nahi na, fir mat karo project na. Why are you working on a project? So those are the important things, you know, which are very, very critical for our direction. So the Jawans came, and students, I must tell you, what we thought our concept would be and what the final product was, it's all credit to those users, right? So a lot of my colleagues are working on participatory design, where users become part of your design process. But of course, we all know that's a very, very important journey. Right. So here we have, you know, how they, you know, take what. Let me quickly show you this one video. type of insights we gain from our user study becomes the core for our comprehension, which is drawing insights. A number of times we do user study, we understand the context, but we never take insights. We never take back these insights as very important cues for our design process. So here we're talking about the cues for the design process. And here we have this very interesting case study of our window-mounted solar oven. It looks very simple, students, but this window-mounted solar oven, for example, uses collaborative design again from three different sort of disciplines. We have professors from energy science who tell us the thermal aspects of the product. We have professors from material science who help us with the coatings. And of course, we have professors from polymer who help us with the polymers and the plastics for it to really work as a greenhouse effect. So here, for example, this oven just has a double wall polycarbonate shell, very simple, and has coated aluminum plates inside, which collect all the, remember our cars get very warm, collects all the heat from the sun, and doesn't let any of the heat escape, and then cooks your rice, you know, within 1.5 hours, 2 hours, if the temperature outside is 40 degrees.
The Design Innovation Center at IIT Bombay supports the best design minds in the country to conceptualize, prototype, test, and ultimately produce innovative products which will enrich our lives. Our student, Avinash, found out that the conventional box-type solar cooker is very inconvenient to use. He came up with this new design of window-mounted oven where one can operate the oven from indoors. We receive ample sunlight in our country and the solar oven takes us a step closer towards a sustainable lifestyle. This versatile solar cooker with zero maintenance can easily recover its cost in a span of 3 to 4 years. The multiple advantages of our solar oven are that it cooks for free, it cooks nutritious food, and the food is tastier.
As an athlete, I always have to perform at my peak. The key is to be dedicated to the idea of fitness. That also means I need to watch what I feed my body.
LPG ki subsidy kaafi kam logon ko diya jati hai. Isi wajah se khana banana kaafi mehenga ho raha hai. आजकल मैं सारा खाना सोलर ओवन पे ही बना लेती हूँ, तड़का भिड़का गैस पर लगा लेती हूँ।
The solar cooker uses renewable energy of the sun and therefore conserves fossil fuels. We have cooked rice, we have cooked millets, various kinds of curries, vegetables, khichdi and things like that.
Because of the lower temperature, the nutrients in a food are more stable compared to other methods of cooking.
The cooking is done in the juices of the food itself and all this contributes to better retention of fragrance and a tastier product at the end.
Fabulous.
The solar oven has gone through many stages of evolution, from a design idea to pilot production. We did multiple tests to improve the efficiency of the solar oven. Thanks to the collaborative efforts of our Design Innovation Center team and the professors at IIT Bombay, we are at the verge of delivering this amazing product from our drawing boards to your homes.
So students, here it is. The insight which the student got when he went to homes was that people want the convenience of cooking from indoors. So that insight brought us to the product, see? So that comprehension becomes very important. One insight which is very critical. And now, when I went to business guys in Surat, they said, sir, aap wo insight to theek hai, par aap isko oven mat bolo, rice cooker bolo. I can sell 1,000 in one go in Surat itself and put them all on the windows. Look at the business acumen coming in there of narrowing down this, you know, further, you know, product, because you have to focus, you know, on the, you know, sale. And again, you know, like to the everlasting, credit of Avinash Prabhuneya, student. Avinash has now joined back with us. So this product, we already taken it up as a startup and we are on the pre-incubator, at IIT Bombay called the Ideas Program. And hopefully, you know, you'll see these products, you know, out there, you know, in the homes of people. So from there, for example, we need to go to our 4C, the check. Of course, creating the key checks, you know, without a check, we can never go forward. I've seen a number of times, you know, most of you, including me, we do a good survey, we get insights, or hum apna checklist barabar nahi karte, or hamara product ek और कुछ हो जाता है बिकॉज वी सो वी डिजाइनर्स राइट वी आर पैशनेट अबाउट थिंग्स. कुछ अच्छा आइडिया लग गया, वो आइडिया अच्छा था करके हमने प्रोडक्ट ला दिया मार्केट में यार. तो आइडिया अच्छा होने से कौन होने वाला है? आइडिया काम करना चाहिए. आइडिया शुड वर्क फॉर द इनसाइड. आइडिया शुड बी विथ योर चेक. अगर मुझे मेंटेनेंस फ्री पोस्ट बॉक्स बनानी है और मैंने वो सब भूल के जब मेरा वो क्लाइंट मुझे बोला यार तुम एक ऐसे पोस्ट बॉक्स बनाओ कि हमें लोग याद रखेंगे. हाँ, कैन यू बिलीव द इंडिया पोस्ट ऑफिशियल टोल्ड मी बढ़िया प्रोडक्ट बना दो यार आईआईटी के आप लोगों. मैं बोला नहीं सर, हम तो हमारा कॉस्ट तो बहुत क्लियर है, मेंटेनेंस भी बनानी है पोस्ट बॉक्स. वो कोई प्लास्टिक का बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग यू नो शेप नहीं देना है आपका. हमें हमें फर्स्ट पर्पस इज मेंटेनेंस फ्री. हमें वो बॉक्स ऐसे बनानी है जो रस ना हो. And you know that's again a big story. I'll show you one after the other. So of course, creating the checklist is very, very important. And students, I must tell you, this is my most toughest and most favorite project, which is the Palki for Vaishno Devi. मेरे को बचपन से लगता था कि यार इनके लिए कुछ जो porters लोगों को उठाते हैं, उनके लिए government कुछ बनाती कभी नहीं है. पर लिमिट डालती कि भाई आप 1,000 रुपया लो या 500 रुपया लो या 200 रुपया लो, तो कितनी गलत बात है ना. उसका मर्जी यार, वो तुम्हें उठा रहा है. इफ यू हैव द मनी यू गो. बट देन आई सेड इफ दे आर पुटिंग रूल्स दे शुड आल्सो प्रोवाइड द टूल्स राइट. रूल बनाओ, टूल भी दो. तो हमने फिर ये प्रोडक्ट बनाया. वेरी टफ जर्नी, 3-4 साल लग गए. मल्टीपल ट्रिप्स टू वैष्णो देवी, माता जी का भी दर्शन हो गया. एनीवे, सो दैट इज द ब्यूटी अबाउट यू नो अबाउट दिस प्रोडक्ट दैट दिस केम आउट ऑफ अगेन collaborative effort. Let me quickly run the video for you over here, students.
श्री माता वैष्णो देवी श्राइन में पहुंचने के लिए बहुत से साधनों का प्रयोग होता है और उन साधनों में पालकी एक बहुत महत्वपूर्ण साधन है और जिसका उपयोग जो है हमारे जो अशक्त और वृद्ध लोग हैं वो करते हैं. लेकिन इस पालकी को कैरी करने वाले पोर्टर्स की बहुत सी परेशानियां हैं क्योंकि उसका पालकी का वजन काफ़ी होता है और 13 किलोमीटर के इस ट्रैक पे उसको ले करके जाना एक काफ़ी जो है एक पेनफुल मैं कहूँगा कि काम है जिसको इम्प्रूव करने की ज़रूरत समझी गई.
पालकी का काम करते हैं कटरा वैष्णो देवी में के माँ के चरणों में. जब हम कटरा से चलते हैं माता वैष्णो देवी के, जब कोई भी पैसेंजर को लेके जाते हैं तो काफ़ी रास्ता है, कम से कम अप एंड डाउन 28 किलोमीटर है.
देखो सर, ऐसे बात है, जब हम चारों मिलके चलते हैं ना तो जब हमारे बाएं कंधे पे जो लकड़ी जो है बाएं कंधे पे होगा, जो सेंटर में बाएं कंधे पे होगा तो दूसरे में दाएं में होगा, तो उसका भी पूरा ध्यान एक एक का बाएं साइड होगा, एक का दाएं साइड होगा, क्योंकि किसी यात्री या किसी भी मजदूर होगा कोई भी होगा कि किसी को पालकी लगे ना. देखो, पैसेंजर तो हमने अपनी जान से प्यारा होता है क्योंकि हमारा रोजी रोटी जो है उसी से दारोमदार हमारा चलता है.
दिस इज अबाउट द डीप कंसर्न ऑफ डॉक्टर चिदंबरम हु इज प्रिंसिपल साइंटिफिक एडवाइजर टू गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया in reducing the drudgery of the porters carrying pilgrims to the Katra shrine, and that's how the redesigning of the Palki project initiated. This very good project was taken up as an integrative effort by IIT Mumbai's IDC division and also NITI for ergonomic studies, and beautifully these people worked for that.
our role in this project was to do a very good user study, understand the needs of the porters very, very closely, and come up with designs which will help them to reduce the drudgery.
Is one place where we have a center of excellence in ergonomics and human factor engineering. While IDC put up a design, we came up with ergonomic studies, their biomechanics system, where the load is coming. We found the shoulder and back were two areas where the lower back was two areas where load was very heavy, and we looked at how we can reduce that load by doing proper design. I think some of the experts also said that so many minute details we as a team has looked at and tried to find a solution which is good for the design.
When we made our first prototype, we had missed out a lot of important issues. Then we had to go with a second prototype, and some more new issues started cropping up. And finally, when we actually made our seventh prototype, the porters finally said, wow, this is done, and now the palki is very good. The final design was lightweight and robust. We could reduce the weight to 34 kilos from around 50 to 54 kilos, and this made a large impact on the comfort of the porters. At the same time, we were very focused on the structural analysis of the palki, and we conducted the analysis that we managed to maintain very good structural stability and structural integrity in the design so that the palki can last long and it can be very safe.
Today I am very happy as this integrative efforts are being concluded, and final solution is emerged is lightweight, ergonomically designed, safety aspects are there, they are all the designs are structurally validated also, and it is also catering to the large age groups of the pilgrims, which are actually will be benefited, and along with the porters' health, and also I am extremely happy. These are all integrative efforts and the guidance from PRMC members and the experts we have got.
और ये प्रोडक्ट तो सबसे मुश्किल था क्योंकि यहाँ जो पोर्टर्स ये कम से कम 30 साल से यूज कर रहे थे प्रोडक्ट को. मैं कुछ भी बदलूं उसमें रिस्क था गिरने का, उसमें रिस्क था टूटने का, उसमें रिस्क था लोड बढ़ने का. So there are multiple risks. And they would not let me move. You will see, we worked on, you know, but of course in design students, you all know, we have to go out of the box first, right? Pehle humne bahut jhakas ideas banaye, helicopter idea, then, you know, open ideas and multiple things. We failed miserably with all these new designs. We made prototypes of this, took them to the field, tried them out, because I didn't want the porters to get locked inside, right? They were used to it. Then we made options with plastic chairs. Plastic chairs would come off within 6 months. So we had to become very... Then we made prototypes of all the CAD models. We tried all these, failed miserably. And finally, the 8th prototype, you know, is what, you know, finally worked. And that is the whole challenge in this journey. Every project, see, the collaborative nature is becoming very, very big here, students. So if we need to collaborate with multiple teams, look at the number of people in this room. All of them are, there are 3 professors from ET. There are 2 professors from IIT Bombay, Professor Desai, who's a structural expert. And there were 4 experts from the principal scientific advisor to the Prime Minister's office. And, you know, and the porters are sitting at the back, you know, all the 4 porters. So when the experts come, you know, we may have our own perceptions. We may also go wrong, right? Whenever we do a project, we be a professor, whoever, there's a review committee which gives valuable advice. So this review committee, we call it the Program Review and Monitoring Committee. It's a collaborative committee, which meets every 1 month and gives you feedback, which is so valuable to take your project forward. So that's a very important part in our journey. And of course, they all tried the Palki out there. So there we go. And then we are very happy now to mention that, you know, finally, Jindal sponsored 100 Palkis. You know, Jindal is, as you know, one of the largest, you know, companies which manufactures stainless steel. Or unka dusra wing tha, Jindal Architecture, which has all this pipe bending and all. Now 100 Palkis are plying in Vaishno Devi for the last 2 years. We're very, very happy. We're coming up with a book. We'll share the book also with you on the Palki design. Here, for example, the check was very important. It was supposed to be a lightweight palki, and we made a conscious decision that the weight should be reduced by 30-40%, you know, percent. So that is the whole, you know, importance of a check. You need to mention the weight. Are lightweight banao to na kuch matlab hai yaar. Mere student aur maybe bahut baar aise galti karta hu ki wo easy to use, lightweight. Iske liye to pura kuch study karne ka bhi zarurat nahi hai na. A product brief or a check should have a value. Chalo, agar maine bola ki palki 34 kilo se 22 kilo na chahiye, aur main fail ho gaya aur maine 24 ban gaya, koi baat nahi, humne try to ki 22 karne ke liye, for example. So that value proposition is very, very important for us to, you know, to match. To isliye abhi check mein ek hi aap yaad rakhna, agar ergonomic study kiya hai to aap bilkul values dena padega. Lightweight mat bolo, the weight should be less than 20 grams if it's in the hand, or the weight should, if it's a wearable mobile or a wearable thing you're making for somebody, the weight should not be more than 40 grams, whatever. Exact weight. Aur wo karne ke liye kya karna padta hai? Insight, user study, gale mein logon ke gale mein taangenge, bhai kitna tumko jamega, fir hum usko brief mein dalenge, if it's a wearable product, for example. So these are very, very small, you know, very important, you know, like learnings for all of us that I'll share, you know, with you. So of course, my next project is my very favorite project called the helmet design. And students, after dekhte hain hamara, like, you know, in our country, what type of options we have and what type of two-wheeler use we have in the country. You know, this is done by my very favorite student called Chari. He's currently working in Fun School in Goa. He's the head of design there. And he made this wonderful sketch for me. He spent nearly a week to make this sketch. But it's fabulous to, you know, make us understand ki hamara product, yaar, ek to hai product ka ek focus hona chahiye, user focus. But hamara user to bahut wide hai. There's an office going person, there's a delivery person, there's a mom who is dropping the children to school, and there's also, you know, like boys who are on the vehicle for fun, and of course there are girls who want to cover their face because of the pollution, and you have the sadaji with the pagdi. Hum itne challenging environment mein kaam kar rahe hain na students. Ek cheez hai to kuch ho jaye na, jaise wo ladki hai piche baithi hai ladke ke, to usko to baal hawa mein udne se acha lagta hai, to ab usko helmet kaise banayenge bolo. To fir humne ek kaam kiya, ये सारे जो हेलमेट के कॉन्टेक्स्ट है ना, एक एक स्टूडेंट को एक एक प्रोजेक्ट दे दिया. तो इसमें अगर मेरे पास हमारे बीडीएस स्टूडेंट्स थे 30, तो हमने 30 बीडीएस स्टूडेंट्स को इसमें से थोड़े दो दो उठाए. जैसे मेरे को मिल्कमैन के लिए हेलमेट बनाना है तो उसके लिए कैसे करूं, उसका पगड़ी भी तो आनी है उसके अंदर, या पगड़ी कैसे यूज होगा. तो एक बहुत अच्छा असाइनमेंट बन गया. सो ऑल द किड्स हैड टू मेक एन हेलमेट थर्मोकोल में ऑफ कोर्स, और पहन के दिखाना पड़ता है कि कैसे थे। और बहुत अच्छा अच्छा आइडिया, ये लड़की के बाल जो उड़ रहे हैं यार, वो हेलमेट इतना सुंदर बनाया उसने कि वो बाल के लिए जगह था पीछे से एरो उड़ने के लिए और हवा चलने के लिए, फॉर एग्जाम्पल। एंड ऑफ कोर्स इट वाज आल्सो, यू नो, वी वुड आल्सो लुक एट द सेफ्टी एंड एवरीथिंग, सो दोस आर द इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग्स। सो वी कैन रियली मेक वन हेलमेट फॉर ईच, यू नो, ईच एप्लीकेशन। और आप देख रहे हो मोबाइल फोन स्कूटर पर बात करते हुए जा रहा है, उसके लिए क्या होगा, उसके लिए बच्चों ने बहुत अच्छे अच्छे आइडिया बनाए थे। And of course, then, you know, this is my, again, favorite topic. Mandar Kale karke hamare student hain, jo abhi, I think he's a teacher, he's a professor. He was in Pune, now he's a professor in Bangalore, teaching design. He worked on this wonderful ideas. Ideas itna important hota hai, aapko product banane ke liye. Or then you have to cluster the ideas as part of what I showed you, and then mock-up models, then prototypes, and of course now this is under tooling, so that we can make the first pilot production and take it to the market. It should be collapsing, but it should not look broken. No, so that's a big thing learning we got from our user study. So that is the helmet design, and of course the crafting. All of us have to have fabulous lab students without crafting. In fact, to the everlasting credit, there is Gayatri Menon, who's my PhD student, now is a professor at NID. She had a student, I forget her name. Usne last year ek motorized wheelchair banaya, students. So impressive. This motorized wheelchair, she collaborated with a company, startup tha wo. Unke saath rakke banaya, wo ghar ke balcony mein usne pura setup bana liya. Carpentry ka, plastic ka, acrylic ka, aur working rig banaya. For that, motorized wheelchair for elderly, which will stand up. उस stand up को क्या आप अपना सामान भी ले सकते हो, ऊपर का bolt लगा सकते हो, निकाल सकते हो। तो मेरा एक student था अभी recently, तो उसने तो पूरा एक solar cooker बना दिया अपने घर में केरला में, और वो यहाँ होता IIT Bombay में तो नहीं बना था, वहां पर था, तो he went to the vendors, got it done, laser cut करवाया, पूरा solar cooker, dish type solar cooker he made in his internship project in the first year, end of first year. So it's just in our minds. And designers, if they don't make mock-ups, if they don't do crafting, unka creativity 1/10 ho jata hai. Woh bilkul yaad rakhna. Bahut zaruri hai. Ideas, of course, are very good, creative. But after creativity, when you don't do crafting, where you make mock-up models, where you make a working prototype, where you make working rigs, all those are very, very valuable, for our thing. So again, again, a very, very favorite project of mine. When you said crafting, mujhe yaad aaya, students, this product was crafted by, all, like our vendors who are everywhere in the country. Jo sheet metal ka fabrication karte hain. कहीं भी जाओ देश में, अपने देश में वो लोग होते हैं, उन्होंने हमारा फर्स्ट प्रोटोटाइप उन्होंने बनाया था, एंड ऑफ कोर्स आफ्टर दैट वी टुक इट अगेन एज इनोवेशन प्रोजेक्ट, एंड देन हम इसमें तो एक बहुत अच्छी स्टोरी है, वो जो स्टेनलेस स्टील की बॉक्स हमने 200 बनाए और मुंह के बल गिरे, एंड सेक्रेटरी ने मुझे इतना डांटा, स्टूडेंट्स आपके फैकल्टी भी आपको इतने डांटेंगे नहीं, सभी को डांट लगती है ना, हम लोग भी गलती करते हैं, वी कैन बी बिग प्रोफेसर्स बट वी कैन मेक अ मिस्टेक। तो उसने मुझे ही पूछा, चक्रवर्ती आपने ऐसे कैसे स्टेनलेस स्टील का बॉक्स बना दिया, सब लोग इसको डस्टबिन सोचते हैं। हमने तो सर्वे भी किया था, सिटी में सब लोग को पसंद आई, पर जब रूरल एरियाज में गया जहां पर पोस्ट बॉक्स सबसे ज्यादा यूज होता है, वहां पर लोगों ने इसको डस्टबिन समझा। और मैं फॉर्म पढ़ा रहा हूं 20-25 साल से, मैं फॉर्म पढ़ा रहा हूं बच्चों को यार, परसेप्शन एंड फॉर्म। मेरी दो पीएचडी स्टूडेंट्स हैं, सुष्मिता शर्मा वर्कड ऑन परसेप्शन एंड फॉर्म, और देखो कैसे गलती होगी। ये गलती क्यों होती है? क्योंकि हम यूजर डोमेन नहीं समझते। ये प्रोडक्ट जो है यार पूरी देश के लिए है, ये खाली सिटी के लिए नहीं है। तो मुझे जो सर्वे करना था पूरा सिटी में करना था, और जब पेपर्स ने बहुत अच्छे अच्छा लिखा तो हमारा ईगो बढ़ गया, हमको लगा तो बहुत अच्छा है। नो, टेक फीडबैक फ्रॉम द यूजर, टेक फीडबैक फ्रॉम द लार्ज सेक्टर ऑफ यूजर्स इफ इट्स अ पब्लिक डोमेन प्रोडक्ट। पब्लिक डोमेन है ये, मेरे पापा ने भी बोला यार पोस्ट बॉक्स नहीं लगता है, फिर भी नहीं सुना। मेरी एनिमेशन कोलिंग ने बोला चक्कू इसमें कुछ गलत है, मेरी एनिमेशन की प्रोफेसर शिल्पा रानाडे, शी इज द हेड ऑफ एनिमेशन, उसको भी अच्छा है, उसको उसने बोला कुछ तो गलत है। दे ऑल न्यू दैट ये पोस्ट बॉक्स नहीं लग रहा है, पर हमारा तो बूथ सवार था, पेट्रोल पंप का एक्सपीरियंस था ना, नया बना दो, सिमेंटिकली न्यू प्रोडक्ट, मेक द प्रोडक्ट लुक जैजी, मेक द प्रोडक्ट लुक न्यू, सो दैट पीपल विल रिकॉग्नाइज इट एज अ न्यू प्रोडक्ट, नया जमाना है, नया प्रोडक्ट चाहिए, वो भी तो है। That was important. So we did finally, you know, like फिर पूरी एक साल हम इसके ऊपर वापस काम करके we designed this new box with all the same values but with a round top with the red color. इसमें stainless steel है but it's a low nickel stainless steel और सस्ता product है. उसके ऊपर हमने फिर powder coating करवाया, फिर lead किया and of course the prime minister also came to see it during our convocation and he had some very interesting questions to ask. अरे आजकल कौन लेटर्स यूज करते हैं? तो मेरे को समझाया सर बहुत लोग यूज करते हैं, अभी भी लाखों लेटर आते हैं इंडिया पोस्ट में. सो दैट इज अ बिग लर्निंग फॉर आवर स्टूडेंट्स. यू हैव टू नो दैट देयर आर पीपल यूज लेटर्स बिकॉज आप मोबाइल फोन यूज कर रहे हो आपको लगता है कि कोई यूज नहीं कर रहा है, राइट? ऐसे नहीं होता. तो वी टू नो ना एवरी ईयर इट इज ड्विंडलिंग ऑफकोर्स द पर्सनल लेटर्स आर ड्विंडलिंग द बिजनेस पोस्ट इज इंक्रीज द अनदर स्टोरी एंड ऑफकोर्स यू ऑल्सो हैव वेरी गुड इनसाइट्स कि आप इसको और मॉडर्न बनाइए, IoT एनेबल्ड कर दीजिए सो लेटर गिरा तो पता लगे लेटर है एंड ऑफकोर्स दिस मल्टीपल फंक्शन ऑफ दिस लेटर बॉक्स. ये तो अपना इंडिया पोस्ट का टोटम पोल है ना, इंडिया पोस्ट का बाहर सिम्बोलॉजी है ये. So that's a very, very important lesson for us. And of course, you know, this was the interesting thing. And of course, the last one, students, is the connection. We say in innovation, you need to connect back with the user. जैसे मैंने वहां पर कनेक्ट किया और मैं फेल हो गया और वापस कनेक्ट करने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ. तो सिमिलरली इन द लेटर बॉक्स, बट इन दिस आई वॉज वेरी लकी वेन आई ज्वाइंड लार्सन & टूब्रो आफ्टर माई MDes at IIT Bombay, where we created the petrol pumps. Which became, you know, maybe you were too young when this came up. You know, this was launched in, of course, 1990, and then became a runaway success. It was supporting all over the country. And then, of course, I went on to work on serial innovation. Every 10 years, we designed a new product, and that is coming up in your journey. So quickly browse through the pitfalls of the innovation process. This is very, very valuable. I think I discussed this with you. अभी रिसर्च जब हो जाता है कबर्ड में चला जाता है. रिसर्च से जब डिजाइन में आता है दैट इज द फर्स्ट पिटफॉल ना, वो अगर क्रॉस कर लिया आपने डिजाइन का मॉकअप बना लिया. व्हेन यू डन द डिजाइन मॉकअप द प्रोडक्ट इज गॉन. थाउजेंड्स ऑफ मॉकअप्स आर अवेलेबल ऑल ओवर द कंट्री इन ऑल द डिजाइन स्कूल्स. छोटे मॉडल बनाए या स्केच बना के छोड़ दे. When you cross from there, which is the second pitfall, आप ये देखें यहाँ तो jump कर रहे हैं research से, यहाँ पर jump करने के लिए बहुत ज़्यादा skill चाहिए यार, बहुत सारा practice चाहिए. तो सबसे मुश्किल काम तो ये है यार research से उसको design में लाना. Take it. So that's a skill which is more important. उसके बाद अपना pole vault आ गया, second pitfall. So from a mock-up, take it to a prototype. Now, so that's a pole vault, right? In pole vault, you're using tools, but you're practicing and you're taking forward. And of course, then you make a working prototype, test with users, aur aapka ek prototype. Ye, most of the startups fail over here. Yaar. Prototype bana lete hain, bola sab kuch ho gaya, sochte hain. So then you need to make a prototype. And from here, for example, the work gets, you need a hot air balloon to, you know, cross this, you know, next pitfall of pilot production, where humne letterbox ke liye 200 banaye, waise pilot production banana padta hai. And of course, when you make the pilot production, you know, you of course use a lot of manufacturing technologies and things like that. And then of course, the final one is an aeroplane, which is much more difficult, where you need much more resources, much more money, much more collaboration to take the product from pilot production to innovation, where, you know, your whole journey is complete. So this is the whole, you know, story, students. Thank you so much for your time.